Well, now that we know about some different organometallic reactions, we're going to start putting them together into some catalytic cycles. So just to review, the reactions that we've learned about often occur in pairs. So for instance, there's an association reaction in which a new ligand brings its lone pair, or sometimes its pi bond, and donates it to the metal to form part of a transition metal complex. The opposite of that is a dissociation, when an existing ligand takes its lone pair or pi bond and leaves the metal behind. An oxidative addition is when there's a new species that fragments into two pieces, and both pieces end up attached to the transition metal. And that can happen a couple of different ways. But the reverse of that is a reductive elimination. Two ligands on the metal come together to form a bond to each other and leave the metal behind. In a 1-2 insertion, which typically we're talking about alkenes, but it can happen with aldehydes or ketones as well, a group, typically a hydride, moves from the transition metal onto the coordinated alkene. A beta elimination is just the reverse, where a hydrogen from the beta position on an alkyl would move over to the transition metal to become a hydride ligand. That leaves also a coordinated alkene on the metal. And finally, a 1-1 insertion is similar to a 1-2 insertion, but it happens usually with carbon monoxide. And the alkyl, or in a few cases, the hydride, moves from the transition metal onto the carbon of the carbon monoxide ligand. Now, there is a reversible reaction for that, but we typically don't see it, so we won't worry about that one. Now, how about a catalytic cycle to apply these ideas? So one of the first catalytic cycles people usually see is a hydrogenation reaction, where an alkene takes up two hydrogen atoms from molecular hydrogen to become a saturated compound. So we're going to build up a cycle for that reaction. And we've got a reminder of that reaction up in the corner here, using the individual reaction types we saw on the previous page. So we've got to bring those two hydrogens and that alkene together at some point. And the two hydrogens are currently bonded to each other. We've got to get them apart from each other. So an oxidative addition seems like an obvious thing to do. We might do this cycle, by the way, in slightly different orders. It doesn't really matter from the student perspective, but this is one place that we could start. And once we've done an oxidative addition, we have two hydride ligands. We could bring in the alkene and coordinate it to the metal. That's an association reaction. And in terms of catalytic strategies, this is an approximation strategy. We're bringing these different reactants together on the same transition metal to allow them to react with each other. To get one of the hydrides onto the alkene is a 1-2 insertion reaction. But to get the other hydrogen on and to release the resulting alkene from the metal is just a reductive elimination. So there we go. We've got an oxidative addition, an association, a 1-2 insertion, and a reductive elimination to get from an alkene to an alkane. That's catalytic hydrogenation.